Hello, our most valued student. My name is Confident and welcome to our 24-minute lesson. This is the ultimate guide in maths, science, career guidance, as well as a sneak peek in my personal experiences. This is a channel that is designed with you in mind. Let us dive into today's lesson. In this next lesson here, where we are looking at the cracking of alkanes, this is a continuation of the elimination reactions. And it is just a small lesson where we look at the cracking of alkanes and what is the definition. You need to know the definition of cracking. It is the chemical process in which the longer chain hydrocarbons molecules are broken down into shorter, more useful molecules. I repeat again, it is a process where longer chain hydrocarbons molecules are broken down into shorter and more useful molecules. Sometimes we find a molecule like this, if it's an alkane, for example, C30HCN+262, like this. See, 30 carbons, and you want it's not useful. Remember, when you talk about petroleum, you find that it has got long chain hydrocarbons, and you want to use this carbon. You want to break it down into smaller, manageable carbons, which are useful in industry. And in industry, you use small chain from C1 to C4, you know, from methane, ethane, propane, butane. Those are the common ones that are used in industry. So that's where cracking now comes in. There is two types of cracking that you need to know. There is thermal cracking. Thermal means heat. So large hydrocarbons are broken into smaller hydrocarbons through heat. A high percentage of hydrocarbons with double bonds are formed. So here you form mainly alkenes with thermal cracking. And then the next type of cracking is called catalytic cracking. Now, what is catalytic cracking? It is large hydrocarbons are broken into smaller hydrocarbons because it's cracking, but in the presence of a catalyst. And then a high percentage of these are branched alkanes and aromatic hydrocarbons are formed. Branched alkanes. So here you form mainly alkanes but with branches. Now, what are the reaction conditions for thermal cracking? High temperatures, high pressure. Don't forget that thermal means heat, but you need high temperature and high pressure. Sometimes it's a problem because to maintain high pressure, you need, now the problem with this is you need expensive equipment. It's difficult to have equipment that can withstand high pressure. High temperatures, I understand, but still it's expensive because you need high volumes of high fuels. You see? So you have to burn a lot of fuel to achieve that high temperature. Again, you need strong walls to withstand the pressure. Hence, they came up with catalytic cracking, whereby you can still do the same thing, but look at the temperature. Low temperatures are now used. Even moderately low pressure, which makes it affordable. It's no longer expensive, but here you use a catalyst, all right, that can be used. Now, example of thermal cracking from pentane into propane and ethane. And let's look at that thermal cracking of what? Pentane. So when you're cracking this, what happens? You do this. You take pentane, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Remember, you're cracking them from long chain. This is just a demonstration. Usually they are much longer than this. So this is what you do. You take from long chain. Are you seeing this? It's long chain. Then here you are saying, what do you have? You have heat and pressure, very high heat and pressure. So what are you gonna have? They're saying you get propane. So let's look at that. Now, if you're going to get propane, because you have to balance the equation, so propane is 1, 2, 3. I hope this is going to be clear though, because of the writing. So propane is that plus, and what else do you want? You want ethene.
then we're gonna look at the balanced equation there. Then all right, now the best thing is to look at the molecular formula. What is this? It's C what? 1 2 3 4 5. C5 H what? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. Right, let's look at this one. C what? C3. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. H8. And this one is C2 H4. But if you add 3 plus 2, it's C5. 8 plus 4 is H12. Do you see that you can form actually propane and ethene from what? From pentane. That is what the cracking does. All right, so having done that, and then the other one says and thermal cracking of octane. We want to crack octane into two molecules of ethene, butene and hydrogen. Let's try that. Octane, so let me take octane, which is what? Octane into two ethene plus butene plus hydrogen. That's what they're saying. So we take octane. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. These are long chain molecules. This is one of the long ones. Remember, we in our syllabus we go up to 8, but we have got decans, nonans, number 9, you know, but we can look at these. But they go up to carbon 30, carbon 60, very large. Now look at this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're going to break into two ethene. So here, when you say this thermal, what you need? High heat and high pressure. Okay, so what are we going to have? Two ethene, which is 1. Because at the end, the equation must balance. This is the first one, plus another ethene, because they say it is 2 of the ethene, plus butene, 1 2 3 4. Are you seeing this? We just have to check if it does balance. Plus hydrogen, which is H2. You can write it like this, but since it's structures, you can put it like that. Now let's look at the formulas. The first one is C8 H what? You can count that. 8 times 2 16 plus 2 17 18. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15. It's 18. Now let's look at this one. Here the first one is C2 H4 C2 H4 C4 H8 and H2 here. So let's count how many carbons. It's 2 4 plus 4, it's 8, which is C8. How many hydrogens? 4 8 16 17 18 H18. See that it does balance. We have done what we mean by cracking. Don't forget the generic part. There are two types of cracking. It is thermal cracking, where you use heat and high pressure. There is catalytic cracking, where you use low temperature, moderately low pressure, and a catalyst. That's why it's called catalytic. But in both areas, when we are cracking, we say it is a chemical process in which longer chain hydrocarbon molecules are broken down into shorter, more useful molecules. They will want you to know that definition. Very important. This definition is very important. They'll say define cracking. And then those are that, and then we're just demonstrating. Guys, nothing much is left. We are going to move on to the next lesson. We are done with this lesson. But as I said, always subscribe so that you can be notified every time there's a new video. Now, what is the next lesson? It's continuing with reaction conditions. These are the last parts now. This is about to wrap up. It is the hydrolysis, substitution. You know, like in a soccer field, this is a soccer field, you know, and then you have a soccer field here, and then you have got teams, you know, they are playing, you know, they are 11 this side, and then on the other side also you've got 11 players with the keeper, and then let's not forget the keeper, let's say they are 11, so 11 this side and 11 this side. Now when these guys are playing, when you are substituting, what happens is you'll find here their substitutes, and you find here on the bench their substitutes. So when one gets injured in a soccer, let's talk of soccer, if one gets injured, you discover, for example, let's say this is number 11, he will go out because of some injury, or he's tired, or maybe the coach is not happy with the type of play he's doing, then you take this one in. That type of thing is called you're substituting. All right, so even in in this organic chemistry, there are such reactions called substitution reaction, whereby something comes in, another one goes out. It's substitution reaction. The first one, hydrolysis, that we're going to look at, and then after that one we also look at substitution in alcohols, and I think that's the main part, and then substitution in alkanes. Those are the three main ones we're going to look at. But guys, join me in the next lesson. This was the part where we were just looking at catalytic cracking, but you need to join me in the next lesson, a very important part also. We've come to the end of our lesson. Thank you.